Our federal police believe they've smashed a major international drug syndicate after seizing a record haul of heist and heroin. The $500 million bust is the culmination of an 11-month investigation that started with a tip-off from the US Drug Enforcement Agency. Eddy Meyer reports.
This is the largest seizure of ice on AFP record and the third largest seizure of heroin. It has prevented up to $500 million of drugs reaching Australian streets.
It's a staggering haul that has amazed even federal authorities. 300 kilograms of the drug ice, another 250 of high-grade heroin. Individual bricks wrapped in aluminium, packed and sealed inside 100 cheap terracotta pots, and then stacked on pallets.
Countless lives would have been affected had this seizure made its way to Australian streets. Whether it be the users, the healthcare workers that deal with drug issues each and every day, or the families that have been torn apart through illicit drug use.
Two shipping containers arrived in Sydney earlier this month, but in a carefully coordinated operation, police and customs had been following the syndicate for 11 months after a tip-off from the US. They knew when they were arriving and what to look for. Finding the drugs then was easy. Customs removed the drugs and allowed the containers to continue their journey to a warehouse.
The actual concealment itself wasn't particularly sophisticated. Terracotta pots concealed in bulk on pallets within cardboard boxes and then shrink-wrapped.
In eight raids this morning, police arrested and charged seven men, four Hong Kong nationals, three Sydney residents. Police say they are career criminals. They face life in prison.
It's easy to say the Mr. Biggs. At the end of the day, there's a lot of Mr. Mediums and Mr. Littles that work with Mr. Biggs. I think we've got a good combination of the people responsible for this importation.
Police believe more arrests will follow. The last financial year proved to be the AFP's most successful in seizing illicit drugs with a haul of 14 tonnes.
Joining me now to discuss the impact of this haul is Juno Vumbaka, the Executive Director of the Australian National Council on Drugs. Thank you so much for coming in tonight. How much of an impact will this actually have in terms of what we're being seen sold on the streets?
In the short term, in the very short term, we may see an impact in terms of availability and price, but the reality is in the medium to long term, we won't see much of a difference. I wish I could say something different, but that's the reality.
Is it hard to gauge? Do we know, you know, the amount of drugs being smuggled into Australia each year? And then in which case, how much of a impact this haul will have?
It's hard to put this into context in terms of it compared to the volume being imported or being sent to Australia. We do know in terms of other previous seizures, this is quite large. It's one of the largest ones. But again, the reality is the hit to the syndicates, the organised crime, is not as bad as what we'd hope with these sorts of figures, because the amount it costs them is far less for these drugs than what it costs on the street to buy.
What would be some of those dollar value comparisons in terms of what we're seeing street value wise and then what kind of hit it would take to those syndicates?
Well, this is where we see the huge markup and the profit incentive for organised crime. At the farm gate in Afghanistan for heroin, it could cost you as little as $900 to $1,000 for a kilo of heroin. Now, on the streets, that can equate to a lot more, millions that would cost on the street. That markup means that the reward for someone prepared to take that risk is incredibly high, and there'll always be people who want to take that risk for that type of reward. The reward, the return on making the trek to Australia with drugs is quite high. That's why there has to be a focus on more than supply. This is about reducing supply, what the police are doing. Critical in any national drug strategy, but just as critical is reducing demand. That means increasing treatment availability, prevention and education.
So while it's, you know, all good and well for police to hail this a huge victory, I suppose there's a bigger message at play.
Yeah, and it is an important victory in terms of it's still, you have to make things difficult for organised crime. You can't leave the door open for them just to ship drugs like this in. And so the police play an important role. But even when you talk to senior police, what they'll tell you is the best way to reduce this is actually to stop the demand for the drugs. That's what will slow the supply down. And that's why investment in treatment, and the research is quite clear that that's where you get your best bang for your buck, is when you put it into treatment.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you so much, Juno Vumbaka, for joining us on the show tonight.
Pleasure.